Want to crack CAT and join IMABC? Hi, I'm Rahul Anand, popularly known as Rahul Sir by my CAT students. I'm an alumnus of the Indian Institute of Management, Ahmedabad. I'm a serial CAT taker with 99.5% in all three sections in CAT. Want to know how my students have grabbed 1000 plus IIM calls? Are you interested to know the four mantras to crack CAT? Let me take you through these four mantras which will ensure a perfect preparation for CAT. So let us start with the four stages of IIM preparation. The first stage is syllabus coverage. Now if you are a fresher, you can afford to take more months to prepare if you have started early. But if you are someone who has taken CAT before and have limited time, let's say you are working, etc., or have started late, then you should try to complete this in a couple of months. The syllabus coverage part is important because there are multiple things apart from revision of the concepts that you have learned at school. You also need to focus on learning the best methods and the solving tricks to solve different types of questions. It's more about mapping types, right? Aptitude preparation for a competitive exam is like you practice n number of questions which come in the exam, and you learn the best methods for them, and then in the exam when similar questions appear, you are able to crack them in the least possible time, right? So coming to the syllabus part, CAT exam, as you might be knowing, has three sections: verbal ability, quantitative aptitude, and the data interpretation and logical reasoning. So let me start with quants. In the quantitative ability section, the most important module according to me is arithmetic, which includes topics like commercial maths, which is percentage, profit loss, then interests, etc. Then topics like time, speed, distance, work, then average allegation, mixture. These are important topics, ratios. The second module in CAT quants, which is important, is algebra, quadratic and linear equations come under it. Then you also have topics like sequence series, maxima, minima, inequality in the algebra part. The third important module is geometry, in which you have polygons, circles, triangles, and 2D, 3D mensuration as the major portion. And finally, there is a miscellaneous part where you have number system, functions, relations, logarithm, set, and permutation, combination, probability, which is a lower weightage. So the first three parts, arithmetic, algebra, geometry, they are the major parts which you should focus on. And the miscellaneous one, altogether, there are a number of topics, but they combine to become the fourth part in the CAT quants prep. So accordingly, give your time to these topics. Arithmetic, you expect 12 to 16 questions out of 34. In algebra, geometry, you expect 6 to 8 questions each, and the remaining goes to the miscellaneous part, right? So, goes without saying, arithmetic is the most important part in CAT quants. The total number of questions are 34. So, I hope you have understood the distribution. Coming to verbal ability, reading holds the key in this section. There are 24 questions, 5 RCs from the reading comprehension section. You need to read fast and then eliminate options. Here, the key is to understand how to read fast using central idea based learning reading methods. Also, you need to run through the RCs fast and then go to the questions and eliminate based on understanding of context of questions. So you should know what are the different question types, and you should learn and prepare accordingly. If you know what the question types are, you will be able to eliminate options better, right? So this is basically specificity and relevance test. This is the kind of practice which you need for reading comprehension. Then you have 10 questions in verbal reasoning, that is based on paragraph based reasoning. Questions like paragraphs, para completion, odd one out, para summary. Again, all these topics, apart from gaining learning context, question types, and elimination frameworks, you should do a lot of reading, CAT relevant reading. Topics like psychology, philosophy, sociology, economics, and contemporary topics like technology, environment, etc. To keep yourself upbeat with the kind of articles which you can expect in CAT. Alright? Third comes the DILR section. DILR of late has been the moderate to difficult section, which is kind of the toughest amongst the three sections. So in DIR, you can broadly classify it into three parts. One, data interpretation. Two, structured LR. Three, unstructured LR. Mostly unstructured LR should be the focus. You expect 4 to 5 sets out of 8 sets. So 32 questions, 8 into 4 each set. So you expect 4 to 5 sets of unstructured LR. Lots of information given. You have to structure and create tables or interpret data given in form of cases and solve these questions. So solve those kinds of questions. Go through CAT 2017, 18, 19 papers and make sure that the exact type of questions which come in DIR, you are upbeat with those questions, right? Apart from that, in the DIR, the structured LR part, you should go through the topics once. Mostly try to solve those questions which involve second level data or involve equation based solving in data sets as well. So if you keep these tips in mind, you will be able to prepare according to the kind of pattern which is expected and is coming in CAT these days, right? So this is the syllabus part. Now on syllabus preparation, in this phase, you should remember a few points. I'll just enumerate those points. First, focus on your weakness. I've seen many students, they are good in maths, they keep doing maths a lot. Don't do that, don't make that mistake. Two, read a lot. Three, do a regular solving practice, a bit on every day. Four, focus on the best possible methods to solve any question. Do not just be adamant and use the same methods that you have learned at school, right? Fifth, always value speed. So try to learn new methods to build speed. Try to read a lot to build speed in understanding. And also try to do calculations on your own. Maybe practice 5 minutes of calculation every day, two-digit multiplication, etc., etc. Basic remainders, right? Just to make yourself fast and to tone your mind in a fashion which would help you cover the syllabus, but also it will help you master the art of solving fast and getting more efficient at it, right? So being effective in your preparation and being efficient, they both matter at the same time. All right. So at B Factory, we encourage these things very much. One, relevance. The preparation should hold a lot of relevance to what kind of exam you are preparing for, right? And we also focus on horizontal learning, which means when you are preparing for, let's say you are preparing for reading, and cover all the types of reading, familiarity, right? When you are preparing one topic, like suppose you are solving one question from time to distance, try to solve that question using relative speed. Maybe also think, can I solve it using the concept of constant variable like distance constant, speed constant, or time constant? Can I solve the same question using some constant, some concept of joint movement, right? Or so multiple ways of thinking. Horizontally, if you start thinking, that is when you transcend from being an aspirant to an expert, and that is when you crack CAT, right? So you should focus on these things. Okay, so the key factors here being maintain a good schedule, right? Set up regular milestones and reward yourself when you finish or achieve small milestones. A sense of achievement helps you keep yourself motivated in good CAT prep, right? Look for mentoring. You can download the B Factory app on Play Store and you can connect with us for iOS. And there is a link under this video on the regular base subscription list where you will get information on mentoring and prep strategy, webinars, etc. So you can follow us there. I would like to help you as much as I can. And apart from that, on your own, remember, don't just complete the syllabus, try to revise it as many times as you can. Many students, they believe in solving and keep solving and solving and moving ahead. They forget that revision is an equal part. How many times do you need to revise? As I said, this video is about how can you go to an IIM or Dream IIM. The answer lies with you. You revise as many times as you can to ensure that you will remember the things in the exam. In the exam situation should not come that you look at a question and you say, your mind says that, okay, I have solved such a question, but I'm not able to solve it. This should not happen, right? It should always be, I've solved this question. Oh yes, I know the steps. Let me run through the steps. So it's about building process memory. So process memory has two parts. One, solve different types of questions and learn the best methods for it. Two, revise n number of times, as many times, so that by the time CAT comes, you will remember the process, the solution process, each and every question type. Alright, so at the end of this first stage, which is syllabus coverage, let me give you the first mantra to prepare. The first mantra to prepare is balance your sections. Do not overweigh or give too much time to one while ignoring the other. Right? Do not put too much time on speed and tricks and forget the syllabus coverage. Do not go into too much depth and forget the coverage of the entire syllabus. Balance sections, balance your preparation. That is the first mantra to assured success. Let us now go to stage 2 and find out what the next mantra is. Stage 2 after the syllabus is done is about advanced solving. In this phase, you should be taking lots of topic tests, speed tests and section tests, and focus on accuracy, selection of questions. These things matter a lot. How does this help you apart from the syllabus, aside from the syllabus coverage? Number one, the kind of level of questions that you will get in CAT, these tests are closer to it, right? So you are building your problem sum toolkit, all right? Point number two, you are practicing basic skills of selection, right? Like it matters a lot. For example, let me take example section by section. You are taking the quant section test, and it's very important in quants that every question, before you start attempting the question, you decide whether you are going to attempt it or leave it. Because if you start attempting every question, let's say there are 10 questions which you attempted but you could not solve, you might have spent 1 to 2 minutes, eventually you are losing 10 to 20 minutes in the exam. So the key to doing well in the quant section is, look at a question, either you know the solution or you don't. You don't need to try. So if you think you can try later, then bookmark it. Else, solve it or leave it, right? So this practice can be done in the sectional tests, so that in the actual mocks, you can work on improving your overall 3 hours test temperament and performance, right? Similarly, in the verbal section, you can work on your sectional strategies, right? You can work on accuracy. In verbal, it's very important to practice when you are sure and when you are not, when you are marking an option, right? Otherwise, if you are always unsure and you mark on your gut feeling, then one day you might get a good score, another day you might not, right? So my sincere advice to all students is to take up at least 1 to 2 months in advanced solving, CAT level solving, and taking lots and lots of topic tests, right? And also section tests. In the real section also, you can the key to the section is that you can actually print and view the whole paper and select a couple of sets, because set selection matters here, and then go on to solve one after the other, right? So small and small tips and tricks, you will find your own ways of doing well in a section, right? As well as working on speed, the timer pressure, right? These things get improved once you practice these tests. So this is the second phase, right? And the key mantra number two here is, learn to be accurate. Got it? The first mantra, balance your preparation across sections. The second mantra, learn to be accurate. All right, coming to the third stage of your preparation. The third stage quite often mingles with or runs parallel with the second stage. We are talking about mock tests. Many students are confused how many mocks to take, etc., etc. If you are a fresher, taking maybe 10, 20, 30 mocks is good enough. If you are someone who is retaking CAT and has already a good percentile last time, but you want improvement, then you might take more. But remember, the number of mocks doesn't matter much. What matters is how you take the mock and how you analyze them. Alright, now as I discussed earlier in stage 2, that every section has a strategy and you can build your own strategy with practice, you can use mocks for the same purpose. But what you should ensure is that you should learn from one mock to the other. The mistakes should not get repeated. Similar type of questions should not get wrong over and over again. Topics you are finding difficult, you should either not attempt them in the next mock, or you should work on them and improve them, right? So strategy of improvement from one mock to the other, that is something which is very, very, very important if you want to go to the top IIM. Alright, so let me explain to you the mock analysis framework which I ask my students to follow, something which has worked brilliantly for many students. The first thing, the one is to two rule. The mock test is of 3 hours, the analysis time should be minimum 6 hours. Alright, divide your analysis into three parts. First, those questions which you got wrong, they are your biggest enemies because they took your time and gave you negative marks. Or maybe if it's a data still, they took your time, right? Go to those questions, go through the solution, learn the solution, right? Means redo it and go through the solution and write down the mistake pattern. For example, if it's a reading comprehension question, write down, got the context wrong, got misread the question, right? Or write down, could not find in the passage, right? What is the type of the error? Mention that. Maybe it's a quant question, write down, silly mistake, write down, conceptual error, write down, something else, right? So you have to write down the type of mistake that you have committed against every question, so that later when you revise your notes, your mock notes, there should be mock notes, a mock analysis copy, got it? So when you revise this, right? You will be able to understand what mistakes are you doing, and before the next mock, revise every previous mocks the mistake pattern, and that is how we learn. I hope you are getting my point. Okay. The next one, the second level analysis is the not attempted ones. Go through the solution and learn. If it was an easy question and you did not attempt, you should think that, okay, I'll be more selective, more attentive in selection next time. If it was a difficult question and you left it, feel good about it, right? Third level is the ones you attempted but took a lot of your time. Ideally, that should not happen. But in case that happened, go through those questions and see if the solution provides something better. Alright, so this level of LOD, level of difficulty analysis and mistake pattern analysis will help you learn from one mock to the other. But there is something else in between. Before you take the next mock, one, as I said, revise the mistake pattern of all the previous mocks every time you take the next mock. Okay. Second, once you have finished this analysis for this mock, right, take another maybe couple of hours, retake the same mock, maybe in the PDF format or whatever. Retake means resolve. That is what is important. Resolve the same mock and now get 300 out of 300. I'm telling you guys, I am a student turned teacher. I have personally prepared for CAT, CRAC, IIM Ahmedabad, and I have been training so many students. I've sent so many students to IIM Ahmedabad and others. I know the psychology. Many students, while preparing, what they do is they take a mock test, they solve the questions which they could not solve, they read it a bit, some they leave. Now, this is something which is not going to help you. Make sure that every question that you have solved in this mock, that doesn't get that type, similar type of question, if it comes in the next mock, it should not be a mistake. To ensure that, retake the mock and get 300 out of 300. Retake in an offline mode, keep your own timer, doesn't matter. But retake and get 300 out of 300. If you're not able to get 300 out of 300 again, right, you will at least understand that your analysis and solution is not going well. And from the next mock, the analysis solution part also you will do more seriously. So if you take a mock on day one, you might end up analyzing the mock for another couple of days. That is how it works, right? So what is the key mantra here? The key mantra, mantra number three, is analysis of mistake patterns. I hope this is clear. Moving on to stage four. In the last part of your preparation before CAT, you revise all the tests that you have taken, all the mocks you have given, you revise all those questions and all the notes that you had studied, and finally you take CAT with confidence, right? After CAT, what comes next is the final selection process, which is VAT or GD and then personal interview. Basic fundamental, let's understand what is VAT is written ability test. So you need to learn how to structure your writing. Group discussion, we know it's a prototype of a team meeting. So in group discussions, again, learn to modularize the topic, break it into parts, add new dimensions, practice with a group of your friends or colleagues. In personal interview, introspect well, think of the qualities and achievements which relate you to being a good management candidate, right? And also, apart from all this, for all this entire process, you should consistently learn to know more about businesses, about economy and about current affairs. Because you know, these things cannot be built just in the last 1 or 2 months when you have your GDPI CAM, right? So all throughout, because if you are a CAT aspirant and an MBA aspirant, when you go for the interview, right, everybody there has a similar percentile. So the interviewer might want to know whether you have a genuine interest in marketing, finance, HR, you have interest in startups or the corporate ecosystem, right? So if you read on a regular basis, you will know more and know better. So I recommend at least once a week or like that, you should be focusing on business awareness kind of reading throughout your preparation. B-Factory has a very nice magazine, Inside Sectors. It's a 490 magazine on industry and company sector information. You can get it from the B-Factory app, right? And in case you haven't, you want to subscribe to all this, I'm again repeating, you can subscribe to the mail list given in the description and download the app, right? It would be the best CAT Buddy app that you can ever get. It's totally relevant to your CAT preparation and your interview preparation. All right. So these four stages, let me recapitulate the four mantras with you, right? First, balance your sections in your syllabus preparation, right? Number two, learn to be accurate. Number three, build and learn from your mistakes, right? So build mistakes pattern, seek improvement from one mock to the other. And number four, in the VAT GDPI for that all, show intent. If you want to do an MBA, read about MBA, show intent. And if you do that throughout, maybe even once a week, or maybe you follow that Inside Sectors magazine, right? It's a fortnightly magazine. You will be able to show intent in the PI room. And that is something which matters a lot when you are aspiring for a top IIM. I hope this is clear. Do not forget to subscribe this YouTube channel. I'll be guiding and mentoring on this channel throughout. All the best. Thank you.